Now, what are foodborne diseases and how they, you know, come into existence? We have seen in our daily lives that, you know, when we eat a food product that has been lying for a long time, and when we consume that particular food product, there are some some results are shown into our body. Maybe that is the indigestion, that is vomiting, or sometimes they are even severe. Okay, and we know that, you know, when we consume infected water or the water that has been lying for a long time, and if we consume it, okay, so there are chances that we get a hepatitis, okay, or jaundice. So all these are kind of foodborne diseases. The water that is lying over there, the food product that are lying for a long time, they get prone to infection, so by microorganisms, and these microorganisms infect, you know, get ingested into our body through that particular food product, and that's how we get diseases. So that is the topic of today. What are various foodborne diseases and how they occur in our daily life, or on how they affect the human body. So what are foodborne diseases? Foodborne disease is any disease resulting from the consumption of contaminated food. Okay, now this is a term that we need to understand. Contaminated food, pathogenic bacteria, viruses, or parasite that contaminate food, as well as chemical or natural toxins. So let's understand each term. Contaminated is when a food product is getting infected by a microorganisms, that is known as contamination. Okay, a human body getting infected or getting ingested by a microorganism, it will be known as contamination. So when a microorganism attacks a particular food product, and that is known as contamination. Pathogenic bacteria, or that could be from viruses, or that could be from parasites. So we have learned in the microorganism chapter that there are various kind of microorganisms like bacteria, virus, parasites, and all. So we are talking about the contamination and what are the pathogenic bacteria, what are parasites, and how they contaminate the food. This contamination is most of the time chemical. The microorganisms which are present in the food, they are doing the chemical reactions in the particular food product, and that's how they tend to multiply in numbers, and as a result of which there are various pathogenic excretion that is developed in that particular food product, and that's how when we consume that particular food product, we get infected. So that is the definition of foodborne diseases. What are the various causes of foodborne diseases? So these are the various causes. Cross contamination occurs when microorganisms are transferred from one surface, okay, or from one food to another food. Okay, so maybe the microorganisms is present onto a particular surface, and food that we are going to cook is in a hand, and then we put onto the infected surface, the food get contaminated. Okay, so when the transfer of microorganism is from one surface to another surface, or from one food product to another food product, that is known as cross contamination. Okay, transfer of microorganisms from one surface to another surface or another food product, or transfer of microorganisms from one thing to another thing. Okay, that could be surface, that could be food, that could be anything. That is known as cross contamination. Okay, another cause of foodborne disease is that time temperature abuse. This happens when we do not keep the food at a right temperature, and it is exposed to to a higher temperature or to a lower temperature. So when the food product goes to a danger zone of temperature, that is 41 degree Fahrenheit to 140 degree Fahrenheit for more than 4 hours, they are very much liable to get infected by various bacteria and viruses. So that is what could be a one cause of foodborne diseases. Next is very general, and you know, this is the most most specific one, poor personal hygiene. When the food handlers or the people who are into the preparing the food or supplying the food or in the processing of food, when they lack basic knowledge of personal hygiene and when they do not practice good hygiene practices, they it tend to create an environment, or it tend to create an atmosphere wherein more of microorganisms can enter into the food product. So these are the basic causes or the reasons by which foodborne diseases can occur. Okay, the first one is cross-contamination, time temperature abuse, and poor personal hygiene. Okay, and this last one, which is a part of personal hygiene, is when we do not maintain good sanitary practices. That's also a cause of foodborne diseases. There are two types of foodborne diseases. One is the food poisoning or food intoxication, and the second one is food infection. Now, what are these and how they are different from one to another? Food poisoning or food intoxication, when we say it means that it is caused due to ingestion of food containing toxins or poisons released by microorganisms. On the other hand, food infection is caused due to ingestion of live or active microorganisms present in the food. Now, there's a basic difference that a particular food product has been infected by the microorganisms, and that microorganism is living there for a long time and has started producing toxins and poisons. On the other hand, the food product has just been infected by the microorganisms, and the microorganism is live in that particular food product and has not started releasing the toxic product. Okay, this is a definition, basic definition of food poisoning and food infection. In case of food poisoning, the incubation period is short. Okay, no fever in most cases, and in most cases it is not non-curable and life-threatening. Okay, when the poisons have been released by the microorganism in the food product, it is very dangerous. On the other hand, when food infection is there, incubation period is long. Okay, the microorganism remains in the body for a longer time, and it develops itself slowly. Fever is one of the most common symptoms in this case, and it is curable with the help of antibiotics. Okay, so these are the differences between the food poisoning and food infection. Some common bacteria or the viruses or microorganisms which are responsible for food poisoning diseases are botulism, Staphylococcus poisoning, bacillary cereus. And for food infection diseases, one is salmonellosis, hepatitis A, and shigellosis. Okay, these are the three main microorganisms which are responsible for food poisoning as well as for food infection diseases. Let's see what these bacteria are and how they affect the human body. The first one that is responsible for food poisoning disease is botulism poisoning. Now, this is a microorganism that is known as Clostridium botulinum. This microorganism is responsible for botulism poisoning. The nature of this particular bacteria is a neurotoxin. When it is neurotoxin, that means it is going to affect the neurons. Neurons means that that means the nervous system, okay, of a human body. Incubation period is 12 to 36 hours. Symptoms is dizziness. Dizziness is related to brain. Neuron, okay, double vision, it is again related to neurons, difficulty in breathing and swallowing. Okay, so these all are related to the nervous system, okay, upper part of the body, the head and all. So that's why they the nature of it is because the nature of the microorganism is neurotoxin. The food commonly involved are improperly canned food, vacuum packed food, or refrigerated food. These are the food products which generally tend to have this particular kind of food poisoning, which is by Clostridium botulinum, and the food poisoning is known as botulism poisoning. Okay. Next is staphylococcal poisoning, and it is caused by the Staphylococcus aureus bacteria, and the nature of the bacteria is enterotoxin. Okay. Whenever it is enterotoxin, it is going to affect the intestine, and intestines are in the abdomen or stomach of a human being. So that means the effect will also be over there. The incubation time is 2 to 4 hours. Symptom is weakness, vomiting, and abdominal cramps. As I said, that the effect will be around the intestine. So weakness, vomiting, and abdominal cramps are the common symptoms of staphylococcal poisoning. Food commonly involved is protein-rich food like milk, meat, or poultry product. Okay, when these particular food products get infected by the Staphylococcus aureus, we get a staphylococcal poisoning. Okay, next is Bacillus cereus poisoning. This is done by Bacillus cereus microorganism, and it is also enterotoxin in nature. The incubation is 2 to 5 hours. Symptoms are weakness, vomiting, abdominal cramps. So see, the microorganism which is enterotoxin in nature will have similar kind of symptoms: weakness, vomiting, and abdominal cramps. Food commonly involved are cereals which are not cooked or preheated on the right temperature. So these are the food products which tend to have this particular kind of food poisoning. Now, food infections. Okay, so this is the first one, that is salmonellosis, and this food infection happens because of this bacteria, that is Salmonella bacteria. The nature of the bacteria is anaerobic in nature, and the type of illness is bacterial infection. Symptoms are stomach cramps, diarrhea, headache, nausea, fever, and vomiting. Now we can guess what would be the nature of the bacteria and where it will be affecting. Okay, stomach cramps, diarrhea, headache, nausea, vomiting. So this will be affecting this is a kind of enterotoxin, okay, which is going to affect the intestines. The food involved are salad dressings, sliced fruit and vegetables. Food sources are soil, insects, raw meat, fish, eggs, and etc. Next is Sigellosis, and it is by Sigella bacteria. The nature of the bacteria is anaerobic in nature, comes from human intestine, polluted water, is spread by flies and food handlers. Okay, a lot of these bacteria and viruses are transported by flies or mosquitoes. Okay, mosquitoes are very small carriers, but flies are a major carrier of microorganisms from one place to another place. Now, type of illness is bacterial infection. Symptoms are diarrhea, fever, abdominal cramp, dehydration. Food sources, food that are prepared by human contact, salads, ready to eat meat, pasta, salads, lettuce, etc. Hepatitis A, this is a very common kind of infection, food poisoning that happens in our daily lives. The virus is hepatovirus or hepatitis A virus, found in human intestine and urinary tract and contaminated water. Symptoms are fever, fatigue, headache, nausea, stomach pain, vomiting, and jaundice. Okay, jaundice is very common factor, and we hear now and then that the jaundice is spreading, and that because of the poor water can available for drinking. Incubation time is 2 to 10 months after contaminated food and water is consumed. Food sources are oysters, raw vegetables, etc. Now, key recommendation for food safety, if we apply all these practices, and we have been discussing these practices since class one, clean, wash your hands, food contact surfaces, fruits and vegetables, whatever product that you are going to use, we should wash them, clean them. Next is we should separate them, separate raw material, separate cooked material, ready to eat food while shopping, preparing or storing. At any stage, we can separate the particular food product. Then cook is the cook food at a right temperature so that it will kill most of the microorganisms in the food product, and chill, which means the chill perishable food promptly and defrost food properly. So whatever food that we have cooked or the food that we have not cooked, we should store it at the right temperature so that when it is going to be cooked or used, it is fresh and free from any microorganisms. Avoid keeping food in danger zone temperature at 40 to 140 degrees Fahrenheit, and maintain personal hygiene. This is very, very important that at any point of time when we are cooking food or preparing food, we should maintain personal hygiene. Then only we can create a safe environment for food production and for the guest whom we are going to serve. Okay, it is very important at home also that we follow these four basic principles of personal hygiene, that is clean, separate, cook and chill. With this, thank you very much for this session.